Adam 22, No Jumper. So for our latest tour, basically we were thinking of doing something in Texas, and Maxo Cream obviously was our first choice, and we started talking to Sasha and the people over at Scoremore. They managed Trill Sammy, so he got on board too. So it was Maxo, Cam Girl, Trill Sammy, and me. I decided that for this tour, instead of just doing vlogs, which is what I did on the first couple tours, that I really wanted to bring a cameraman along and try to do something a little bit more official. While we were in the planning stages of the tour, obviously tragedy hit, and the Hurricane Harvey hit and destroyed tons of property and all kinds of shit in Texas. And the craziest thing about it is that Maxo, he basically posted on his social media about how his family was stranded there during the flooding, and his fans actually went and saved his family and like transported them back to safety, which I thought was a pretty incredible story. So I figured that, you know, since we were going on tour and since we were going to be meeting a lot of people who were personally affected by the hurricanes and everything, that it was just a good opportunity to sort of do something good. So we teamed up with Trey the Truth's charitable organization. He's been going crazy. Like, he hasn't been doing anything in the rap lane so much. Yeah, I actually met him at the Houston show, and he was telling me that he hasn't been doing anything music wise. He's just been 100% out there helping with the relief effort. So it was a huge honor to get to raise money for his organization, just as a big fan of his music and everything that he does for the community. When we go on tour, typically there'll be some openers and everything, and then me and Cam Girl, we go out and she DJs, I'll go out there and just basically, you know, turn up with the crowd.
Hey, who out there fucks with No Jumper?
Like, I'll pull out my phone just to vlog, and these kids go absolutely insane.
I go hard in the motherfucking paint, nigga. Leave you stankin', nigga. What the fuck I thinkin', nigga? I don't die for this shit, or what the fuck I say?
To be honest, like, when I first started doing it, I did not know that that was going to be something that I actually genuinely enjoyed, but over time it's definitely become something that I really get into. Like, even just taking their phones and Snapchatting and everything, it's definitely a good time, and Kim gets really into it too.
Yeah, I came in with a saw. Ooh, yeah, I came in with a saw. Yeah, bitch, I flare it raw. Yeah, bitch, I flare it raw. Yeah, yeah, I came in with a saw. Ooh, yeah, I came in with a saw. Ooh, bitch, I flare it raw. Yeah, bitch, I flare it raw. Yeah.
So we started out in El Paso, which was the first show of the tour, and I think it was the smallest one.
Hey man, it's my first time in El Paso.
That was pretty funny because we were right there on the border. Like, you could literally just see Mexico right over there. It was only a couple miles away. Oh yeah, we booked a flight wrong when we were leaving El Paso to go to Dallas. Or actually, Kim booked the flight wrong. But it only ended up costing like $200, so wasn't that upset about it. But yeah, we definitely had to spend an extra night in El Paso doing pretty much absolutely nothing. We had an off day where Maxo went and played Rolling Loud. Yeah, Cam Girl, I always just love seeing how she is on the road. She doesn't like being on camera when she doesn't have her makeup on, so she wears that weird mask. She handles it very well. She's very very tough, very thorough. You know, she can handle the situations. She's not easily flustered. She's good at getting stuff done. I seen her yell at an Uber driver. It's amazing, you need that. And it's cool, because she's a girl, so she's kind of like, off limits. Like, she can scream at someone and like they're not gonna like hit her. She's a girl. Our next show was in Dallas. That was tight. We actually had Smoke Perp come out and hang out with us while he was on the Post Malone tour. Houston was the biggest show by far, because we basically decided that we wanted to do a free show since they were so affected by the hurricanes and everything. So we just had so many people come out, and the energy was just absolutely insane, just having that many people in there. It was just ridiculous. Like, everybody who walked on stage was getting cheered as if they were like a superstar. It was pretty wild.
This is my guy, Winter Kitchen. He's about to come out and perform the No Jumper anthem to get this shit started.
That's Rizzo's hometown, so, you know. But yeah, Austin was amazing. Like, just Austin, I spent time living there before, so like it was nice to be back. And the fans out there, also, Austin's just like a super music driven city, so they were going crazy. My man Rizzo showed up in Dallas, which was pretty amazing just to have him around. He's like one of the funniest guys that I know. He's part of the whole Sauce movement, and he's just a hilarious character. So he was coming out, turning up on stage with me and everything.
Rizzo, kind enough.
Y'all have a good time out here in this motherfucker.
1, 2, 3,
it's high.
Let's go.
Hey,
if y'all know the song, let me see if y'all sing it, man.
Big Texas shit.
First night of the show was funny because it was my first time like actually getting to like really hang out with Sammy and actually get to see him perform live and everything, and get to see in particular how crazy these girls were going about him. Like, they just absolutely lose their mind for him too.
I'm about the music. I ain't really just trying to be fucking my fans and shit. So real Sammy from Houston, Texas, you know, 19 years old. Yeah. Born and raised in Houston, Texas. I just moved to Los Angeles like a couple months ago. But yeah, born and raised Houston, Texas, south side of Houston, Texas.
Growing up in Houston, you know, it was just a culture out there. It did just everything from the drink, the swingers and all that. It's live to go out there. Yeah, I get a lot of love in Texas. You know, the fans are crazy. They be down for whatever. The energy is crazy. Just grab their phone, make a video, take a picture, whatever. Real quick. I like doing that shit, so. You know, shout out the fans. For sure. Like, all the fans, like, that been there from day one, like, from the freestyles and all that shit. Niggas be going crazy in the mosh pits. Crowd surfing, all that one shit.
And that's how I feel today. I wanna make the cake and eat it too. I need a bitch around to keep it cool. These are some $1,000 tennis shoes. Baby, don't look down, look around. Every city smoke a pound. Gave Ace Town a new sound. And I'm still gonna hold it down. And that's how
I was walking at this like a motherfucking tightrope. I had walked like halfway through it. And was like, what did I get into? I can't walk back, so I just had to finish walking that bitch and just jump in the crowd somewhere. Every show be lit, really. Cause I already been there, so I know what to expect.
We were traveling in Sammy's Sprinter from a few of the different cities in between. So we got to see what it was like cooped up in there. Basically, Sammy just like smoking 5 million blunts.
Smoke. I'll be smoking, sleeping, playing my Nintendo Switch.
Sammy and his whole crew, like his crew is fucking hilarious.
Daisy! Mike, it's a surprise.
Daisy! Get the mic!
Get your ass out of here! I thought we threw you out last night on the highway.
Yeah, everybody gotta be doing something important. You know, I got the cameraman, my nigga Figs, Tristan, the video man, you know. Twin just do whatever. They can't believe that one. Yeah. No one ever believed Twin runs nothing. Osama the fashion plug, you know, like all with the off-white and everything, all the exclusive shit at Nick's Bodyguard, you know. He know how to move. He did. He good communication. That's my nigga. Oh, I forgot the DJ. What Mike Ness said? That's a squad, you know.
Hold on. Wait a minute. You better let me through the door.
Y'all ready to turn up?
I said y'all ready to get lit for real.
I'm ready to keep
getting lit. Bad bitch from New York, so I fly to the H. Shawty thick as hell, yeah. Then the Birkin on the waist, Uber every fucking where. Backwoods in a zip, and I think that bitch a thotty, so I kicked her out my whip.
so much camaraderie within like all the dudes that he's around and stuff, and they just all drive around in the Sprinter, and like it was just so hilarious getting into that environment and seeing up close and personal how bad they were picking on each other and how many weird inside jokes they had going on. You know, I love that because I'm used to that, like going on tour doing BMX stuff and everything, but to see that amongst Sammy's crew was pretty hilarious, just to see them all roasting each other.
My man's Figs, man, my camera, and of course, man. I'm sorry, bro. You just vulnerable, bro.
Figs was the victim. Figs was the one, you know, you say it's your friend's birthday, so they bring out the cake or whatever, and they sing to you and everything. And it's so funny because he's just sitting there with his head buried in his phone, just trying to pretend it wasn't happening while he's having this big birthday celebration.
He's interesting.
Hey, Twin gotta get on this one.
Twin, bro, what's up, Twin? Everybody know Twin, man. He did big dog.
Big dog Twin, man.
What we doing,
Twin?
We just talking?
Yeah. Look, definitely.
Hey, if
fun,
I give
man.
You the go yard, you can't be giving it to Sammy because you're not going to get it back.
No, I remember this.
Oh, okay.
I
gave that man my.
Yeah, I let him have custody of the go yard because I got the Gucci.
I lost my
Gucci rider. You lost your Louis?
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, Fizz got the white go yard.
Famous.
You know what I'm saying? We just do all that one shit and we just make it work.
Yeah, man. Make it happen.
Real talk. Make it happen, Captain.
Sammy don't never pass the wood and shit, so.
Yeah, whoever watching this.
Hey, you got a backwood. Hey, it should be multiple woods in the air.
Just give yours to Sammy. Right. And you better like Charles after that was.
Don't even play with me, P. I'm fresh pack.
Yeah, don't you should have enough weed.
Yeah, exactly. Don't look down, look around. You better have enough weed to smoke.
Yeah.
What, how you want a big dog flashlight? Yeah. Just one shit.
Keeping it down.
Wow.
You gonna work on that?
Sweet.
That's pretty amazing, bro. Y'all gotta understand. Big time on a durag. That's like amazing.
You better keep it on.
You got a little bit more pep in you. We got our bodyguard Nick right there. That's Big Dog right there. He making sure we straight everywhere.
Hey, okay, little bro.
Mike Nasty, funny. He from Naptown. He been rocking with us for about 2 years now.
And Max.
Max was on the tour too. Max on the bus.
We gonna go ahead and go up there, and then everybody else add on to the team. Got to be legit. And that's all we got around us, is solid people.
Then I go, 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 yo. I just get a check. Then I go, 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 yo. Down in other racks, I need mo, racks. Down in other racks, I need mo, yeah. I just get that check. Then I go, 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 yo. Drinking all this lean, baby, bottles on the floor.
We just got a whole lot of big dog shit going on. That's it. That's final. You know what I'm saying? That's how we gonna wrap that one up. That's it, Jack.
You know, I've been knowing Maxo for a couple years now. I was a huge fan of his music, was super, super excited to get his interview in the first place when we got it. So to do a tour with him in Texas was a no-brainer.
Make some noise if you fuck with Maxo Cream!
Maxo! 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 Maxo!
Man, well, I'm from South Indy, Texas. Murder Block, you feel me? Vaughn Park, like, nigga, that shit, that street is the murder capital of Houston. That street have more murders than goddamn whole sections and size of Houston. You know what I'm saying? So shit, my little Crip niggas, they see shit, they don't really, niggas don't really even get the chance to live life. They be having families before they adults. Shit like that, fucked up shit. So them seeing me do shit, like I get to bring them on tour, take them out the hood, that opened up an inspiration for them. Cause them niggas be looking at them like, man, I'm gonna be dead or in jail. For real.
I got Texan glass, AK-40 chops. I ain't got a box, pop a couple shots. Call my plug a lot, 10 pounds, I'm a cop. From me six off top, all I do is shop. You don't like the pot, come and swap it out. Rip and run and swat, I be on the blocks. Niggas serving grams, I can't serve a zip. How do I get a ship, give it to my crates.
Them niggas, they grind, they janky. I'm nah, bitch, y'all's fucked up. We riding Benz, we ride Supreme. We fuck hoes, we piped up. What the fuck you talking about? I'm putting off of my section, really giving them niggas hope. When I was that age, I ain't see that shit, you feel me? So it's good, you know what I'm saying, give them something to fall back on. That's for every, from goddamn all across America, nigga, all across the world, you feel me? You can do that shit. You gotta stay 10 toes down, not give a fuck what nobody say, bro. I'm just doing your shit.
Inventory style, money come and go. Bitches of the kids like the ice cream, man. I was buzzing down zips, selling grams hand in hand. Clientele picked up, bought stuff since then. Mix my leg with the pumps, can't feel my skin. I'm good with the lean in the Viking and tagging them. Downstairs, huh, with the press in them. Chill. Swapping, no swapping, get your whole trap too. Bang, beat game, this girl like.
Tweet out. Know what I'm saying? On Snapchat. I put the address and shit, woo woo. I'm missing Red Cross people. And they end up pulling up, helping out, you feel me? And then in the middle of helping out, they realized that it was my crib. They called even more people. That extra help. My people was on the roof. You feel me? Because it was the one story house that had been flooded and shit. So they came, helped out. After they saved them, they came back, helped clean out the house, fix everything. And I had like some leftover Persona tape CDs. I gave it to them. Shit like that, you know, they was just real, you know, loyal. I gotta give my mama another house. Got another house, you feel me? Was good. Got a two story.
I got clientele. Bust a bag, then drop it on the scale. Get a pack next day, do the mail. Fuck 12, don't wanna go to jail. Hit a block and the fiends raise hell. Got 30 act pints in a freezer. High tech red, got it by the leader. iPhone 2 way in the beeper. Yeah, my trap say jumping off the meter.
This one that I'm gonna say, I don't give a fuck about how nobody feel. He's some dick rides and try to dictate their own select few of niggas that they thought was gonna be on, and it wasn't that, nigga. And I feel like I was the first young nigga coming through kicking down the door, 2012 with the Whitney Houston's and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? Coming through, doing underground YouTube, you know, hitting a million on YouTube. But they used to put these certain things on pedestal that was lame as fuck. 2 years doing 14,000 views and shit like that. I feel like I kicked down the door for that. After I kicked down the door, boom. Sauce Walker followed me, boom. Then Trip Semi followed me, boom. And we actually came up with real buzzes, real shit. Not this dictated ass bullshit, you know what I'm saying? We ain't get no help for no OGs, no nothing. We did that shit, bro. And now you don't see that shit no more. Nobody talking about them niggas. You said No Jumper Tour with Maxo Cream and Trip Semi. Cause that's what the fuck going on out here in Houston. Like, I know a lot of rappers, but oh, I'm exhausted. Ooh, fuck that shit. This rap shit is a trap, my nigga. So every day I get money to do that shit, I love that shit. I don't get tired, no Kevin Gates. Missed calls, bitches from the night before, don't even know the fuck they is, don't say their number. Smoke a blunt, crack jokes, go eat, do the same shit all over again. Wake up, forget what the fuck happened, do it again. What's on, what are we doing? Fetty. Fetty me a lot to me, bro.
Sing it loud, sing it loud, sing it loud.
Fetty on, Fetty on, Fetty.
Shipping a pack in his vacuum seal. 30 on 40 G deck of steel. Tip out a pint, I'ma crack the seal. Shut on my side like a Navy seal. 3 in the morning, we trapping steel. Not that Corolla, the Batmobile. Don't trust that nigga, cause he gon' spill out.
I'm a young OG. I'm still a young nigga, but I'm older than these young niggas. Like most of the young niggas, they come in the game, you know, they salute me, look up to me, you know what I'm saying, bro? Like, from everybody, like, when I first met Dix, when I first met Trippy Red, from Cardi to Uzi, it was like, you know, I got the respect. It's like, with this shit, it ain't no shade of gray. You either like a mama rap nigga or you like a yo got a trap rap nigga. But I feel like I bridge the gap to that. From the trap rap, I go pull up on trouble young scooters. You know what I'm saying? Goddamn gangster niggas. And I go kick it with, you know what I'm saying, little bro Cardi and shit like that. Only nigga like me could do that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I look at Maxo Cream and Young OG. That's when I am, from Texas to all that shit. You feel me? I gotta drop this damn project and drop another one. You know what I'm saying? Just keep stay consistent. Cause when I came in the game, it was like on some lyrical shit. Like, when I came in the game, it was like Chief Keef was just starting to crack. But it was like, has J. Cole's, your Kid Cudi's, your Wiz's, your Currency's. That was my persona. I was robbing, kicking those, shit like that. And now, but I was still lyrical. Now it's like, you know, niggas wanna have feel good music and shit like that. So, in the middle of my career, is a whole transition. From the iMemes and the live mixtapes to the SoundClouds to the Apple Music, all that shit. So I really got caught in the transition. They caught me off guard with shit. I don't give a fuck. I still got my fans. I'm gonna keep doing me. Keep rocking shit. You know what I'm saying? Shit. I'm gonna keep doing Maxo. As long as they fuck with it, I'm fucking with it.
Hey, fam. How many of y'all fuck with my little brother Trill Sammy in this bitch? Left side, hands up, tight up, bow, right side.
Shit, I've been doing gangsta like long time, even before I started rapping. It was always like rapping and shit, everybody knew gangsta.
But we just in the studio making shit. We knew we was gonna do this tour. You know what I'm saying? My manager his and scoreboard and all this going back and forth, so they're like, shit, I'm gonna do some songs.
We just rocking because we both from the same city, so we just both trying to put on.
It was just natural. The shit actually go up. I ain't know it was gonna go up like that. I'd be performing, I'd be like, yo, what's on y'all need? Like, Harden. You know? It is natural.
Bitches bopping on me, massaging, kissing, and hugging. Pippin' gray, pop champagne, we drinking
one. Yeah, overall, tour was a big success. I'm very happy to finally get to do something in Texas.
Tour was lit, man. Glad I could help all the hurricane victims, man. Appreciate No Jumper.
She came by, it was cranky. Texas tour. You feel me? Went crazy. I ain't doing a show in Houston. Many. You feel me? I want to get something back. I always talk about doing a freak show. Like, Tristan, people hit me up. I was at school, and they're like, man, this is a damn tour. I'm like, come on, let's get it. And they said No Jumper was on. I'm like, bet.
It was crazy to see how Sammy and Max are both like treated like total fucking legends. Like the kids just go crazy for them both. Like it's just they're the, you know, the biggest heroes to those kids just because, you know, they're actually putting on for Texas and Texas has so much pride.
Dallas is crazy. It made me feel like, cause you know, like now, like the more shows I do, it be barricades, bigger, like, you know, 1,000 cap, you feel me? I missed that 400 cap in a personal goddamn where I can fuck on stage out, they might kick me 5 seconds, then drop my fat ass, you feel me? And I felt like that with Dallas. It really showed that love.
Alright, number one. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Support No Jumper. Yeah! Punk Gang, Trill Sammy, Maxwell Cream.